this thing looks sick. Two main takeaways. I might even have three, but we'll start with the first one. So the first day of the event, I picked up a lot about learning about different social media channels and how to use them effectively. Obviously, we all know social media is popular. Like, people use them to, you know, make money, obviously run their business on them and all that great stuff. But how do you use it effectively, right? We all know Instagram, we post a quick boomerang picture. You post some good pictures. That works, of course. But how do you use Snapchat effectively? How do you use Facebook effectively? How do you use podcasts effectively? YouTube, all that stuff. So for me, learning how these like top internet guys are using these platforms officially and how they really capitalize on them was huge for me, because I know for a fact that I could do a lot better of a job utilizing each channel effectively. So for me, you know, focusing in on narrowing down what specifically am I trying to get across. So I know for a fact I want to start focusing on, you know, we were talking about starting a podcast.
Yeah.
And just focusing on specifically setting up content for podcasts, right? So one mistake that I see a lot of people do, where I might have done it myself, is thinking that we can just record any kind of content and just use it for all social media platforms.
Yeah.
That we spoke about that, and that seemed to not be as effective, of course, because same type of content isn't going to be consumed everywhere. For example, people might consume podcasts when they're driving or working out. So making like a video that's like a screen share when I'm like typing on my computer, yeah, things like that, that wouldn't really make sense to transcribe it into a podcast. So knowing how to create content that's effective for every single channel and doing it correctly. Russell Brunson was talking about he was making these podcasts in his car for the people that are listening to them in their car while they're driving. Yeah. So it just made complete sense. That was one huge takeaway. One of the biggest things we learned in sales, and for those of you guys that don't know, me and my business partner Samir, we did sales, door-to-door sales. We learned a ton. Obviously, probably like the most life-changing lessons, I would say. But one of the biggest things that we learned was if a customer or anyone likes you and they trust you, they definitely will buy from you. So one challenge that a lot of us face within social media itself or just online is really building that relationship with people, right? And how can you do that? Well, one of the ways you can do that is by being transparent. That was huge, because I honestly, like, we think that we show a lot of things we do, yeah, and we're transparent, but like we could probably be showing a lot more.
Yeah, the weakness, the vanity part of it.
Yeah, right? Really showing weaknesses is huge. By the way, shout out to lady entrepreneurs, any ladies that are watching, we need more lady entrepreneurs. So if you're thinking about getting started on any business, you should. Samir said to call me or him. That's cool. We can help you guys out with e-commerce, dropshipping, whatever the case may be. We had some lady entrepreneurs that were presenting on stage and they absolutely crushed it. And one of the biggest things that really helped them take off in their careers and with their business was one of them was showing her pregnancy and like how she was like in a photo shoot and was working out after pregnancy. And I guess it's like a thing, like after pregnancy, you tend to have to, you know, pee a lot. I guess that's a woman's thing. I don't know. That's what she was saying. Yeah. But she peed her pants and literally she used that same picture that she had of her working out and peeing her pants and literally went viral. Literally that picture went viral for her and it helped her a ton in her business. So being transparent obviously helps a ton. So I want to focus on that as well.
This lady that he's talking about was called like a scammer. Not a scammer, but she was just bad mouthed by somebody within her program. She was super frustrated. So what'd she do? She went live on her Facebook group.
Yep.
And she was like, dude, I'm super sad. I'm pissed off.
Yeah, that was crazy to hear, because that would take some major cojones, yeah, to just pop up alive and like.
She was bawling.
She was literally crying, going over all the negative things that people said about her and just literally confronting them. Yeah. And she was thinking like, what if those same people that were trolling her were like on that live? Like,
yeah,
how would that make her feel? But the fact that she did that honestly made her connect with her customers and, yeah, her potential customers on a whole different level, because now she had this community where like people know that any problems they had, they can come on there and share it. I feel like nothing else like emotion can build relationships or connections, because obviously we can all connect when somebody's being emotional or, yeah, like, you know, we all want to help out and see how we can do better for them. So that was honestly huge to see that, because obviously we don't see too much of that or hear too many people's stories and how they've been able to build off, yeah, of things like sharing things that have happened to them in the past. So that was honestly huge. Two huge takeaways. Fun fact, it's my first, me and Samir's first time in Orlando. We've been to Miami,
place,
but Orlando's incredible. We're staying by Disney World. Personally, growing up, like, Disney World was never like even possible. Disney World was like a myth for sure, because first off, I'm from the hood. Dorchester people don't ever go to Disney World. Chuck E. Cheese is the most that we get, or Good Times for those of you guys that are from Boston and remember. But Disney World is like this myth. I don't even know how I could even come to Orlando, let alone Disney World alone. And we're staying at a pretty nice place, but honestly,
I wish you guys were here with us, right?
Yeah, for sure. Super grateful to be able to be part of this event. And this event was not cheap. I gotta say, one of the best investments anyone will get is always investing in yourself, because again, literally coming to this event, we get to learn a ton first off, and you get to connect and network with other entrepreneurs. If you guys picked up a thing or two on this video, make sure you drop a like. Also, leave me a comment below. Let me know if any of you guys have been to Orlando or if any of you guys are from here, because I'm always open to connecting with a lot more people. And if you haven't already, make sure you join the VFAM, smash that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.